Oh, what is up everyone? Polartron here, back with another reaction video. And today we're going to be checking out another Brew Stew reaction. We're going to be doing Brew Stew board games. I like board games a lot. If you ask me what's my favorite board game, I'd either say, probably Monopoly and Jenga. I don't know if Jenga counts as a board game, and I like the Game of Life. But yeah, let me know what your favorite board games are, and without any further ado, let's start watching this. Before we do, subscribe to the channel, like the video, comment down below, and we are starting out right now.
Alright, now when I was a kid, board games were a big source of entertainment. And like most households, we had a whole cabinet full of board games when I was growing up.
I like Operation 2.
I say that some board games are better than others. So what I'm gonna do today is go through and grade all the board games I had as a kid, from the really, really great games all the way down to the turds of disappointment. First up, the Game of Life. Now, Life is a pretty good game, I have to say. The only problem I have about it is that it's not very realistic. Every space on the board was like, climb a mountain and adopt a puppy, collect $40,000. Like, what the hell is that? That's not real life. Where's the game of real life at? You need spaces with real life situations, like, income tax return, collect nothing because of your back child support, or overdrafted your bank account because you were drunk on Amazon. Don't do shit for the next 7 turns. The Game of Life is fun, but it's fake as hell, so I'll give it a B-. Next up, Sorry. Now, Sorry is a fantastic game. Any game where you can screw over your friends automatically makes it a great game. You draw that Sorry card,
I like Sorry
and you turn into a little bastard. Oh, well, fuck you, Michael, and the horse you rode in on. Knock his piece out to the kitchen and shit. What's not to like about it? You can be a dick all you want, and you don't even have to apologize because the goddamn game does it for you. Sorry gets a B+. Keep it up, you're doing great. Next up, Scattergories. Also known as Anxiety Attack in a Box. Now, the concept of Scattergories is simple enough.
Oh, it's like you Pictionary.
You roll a die with a bunch of letters on it, and then boom, pop quiz time. All your answers have to start with the letter R. But then you gotta watch out for the assholes that get a little too liberal with their answers. Okay, foods that start with the letter R. What do you got, Uncle Rick? Really yummy spaghetti? God damn it, Rick, what kind of bullshit answer is that? Jesus Christ, no wonder why your wife
is brother
that
or something?
Garbage man in Seattle. Scattergories gets a, we'll give it an R for a really shitty board game. Next up, Mousetrap. Mousetrap was a pretty fun game, right? No, I'm asking a question. Was Mousetrap fun?
I think
fun?
I saw this game, but I never got a chance to play
it. Damn thing up. It took longer to set up the goddamn Rube Goldberg contraption than it did to actually play the game. You had potential, Mousetrap. Maybe if my fucking SAT scores were a little higher, I could enjoy you. You get a D+. Let's move on. Next up, Yahtzee. All right, now I know I'm gonna probably piss some people off here, but Yahtzee blows ass. I don't know whose crackhead uncle came up with the game.
I don't like
loud,
that game.
And it's boring, and half the time you're just staring at your meemaw for 45 minutes while she contemplates going for a fucking full house. Make a move, Grandma, your time is running short. Just take your chance and let's get it
I don't like it. It's
Yahtzee
like it's like less fun. It makes it more of homework.
Oh, cool. Let's do homework. That sounds fun. Fuck Boggle, it gets an F as well. Next one, Clue. Now I have to admit,
roasting
like
every game.
Times when I was a kid. And all I really remember is something about a candlestick and Mr. Green looked like my fucking 6th grade math teacher. Clue gets a D, just like I got in my 6th grade math class. Next up, Trouble. Now, Trouble is a terrible game.
I don't know what that is.
It's just a shittier version of Sorry, after all, with an equally shitty bubble popper that barely even works. 4. God damn it, roll something besides a 4. It's still 4. God damn it, I'm getting pissed off just thinking about it. Shitty Sorry gets an F. Let's move on. Uno. Technically a card game, not a board game, but you're not my dad and you can't tell me what to do. Now everybody relax, I think Uno is a fantastic game. Once again, it's a game that you can screw over your friends. What's not to love?
I like
Uno.
Even
if you're getting your ass beat and you're struggling to hold your 47 cards over there, it still feels good to slam down that wild draw 4 now, doesn't it? Boom, draw 4, kiss my ass. Michael, what the hell? You're holding like half the deck in your hand. You don't have a blue card? That's none of your goddamn business. Now pick up 4 cards. God damn it, well what color do you want? Oh, I don't know, how about blue? It was blue to begin with, god damn it, are you serious? The only problem that I do have with Uno is that it sucks ass playing with just 2 people. You can screw around and win the game in just 1 turn.
Yeah.
Skip, reverse, skip again, reverse, reverse, draw 4, Uno, blue 7. I win. What the hell just happened?
Whoa,
so
that's...
Go ahead and give Uno a B, and if you're playing with just 2 people, it gets 2 draw 2s and go fuck yourself. How about that? Next up, Scrabble. Now, I like the game of Scrabble. Or let me rephrase that.
I think it's all right.
The game of Scrabble. until I played it with my wife. Because my dumbass will be over there, staring at the board for 45 minutes. There we go. Pop-Tarts. 12 points. Then 5 seconds later, my wife pumps out some bullshit word like, oh, this one's easy. X-I-B. Zib. It's a word from Kenya. It means orangutan. Triple letter, triple word, 84 points. So like Uno, we'll give Scrabble a B, and if I'm playing against my wife, it gets 3 draw 2s and a go fuck yourself. Now you might be sitting there like, wow, this guy fucking complains a lot. Is he ever gonna grade any board game with an A? Well, you bet your ass I'm gonna. And if it's not obvious already, that game is Monopoly.
Monopoly,
now, I've
yep.
Made a whole video about A plus plus. As a kid. And now as an adult, it's pretty much the same thing. The only difference
and
is that
the
game starts out with a warning from my wife. Don't fucking trade with Tyler. He's gonna rip you off, and the game's gonna end. Don't trade with him. Now, do I really rip people off in Monopoly? Well, yeah, you bet your ass I do. That's the whole point of the game. But is it fair that I have to get fucking embargoed the whole game just because of who I am? I don't think so, but it doesn't matter. Because in the end, somebody always cracks. I'll toss up a trade with somebody, and I'll pretend that it's an even better deal for them than it is me. Hey, Bobby, I see you got that hunk of shit Kentucky Avenue. You see, I was thinking about trading these two railroads for it because, well, I'm just making too much fucking money with them. Don't do it, Bobby. It's a
lot
wreck.
Of people
He's
don't know how to
reds.
Play Monopoly.
Bobby, relax. It's me, the devil.
Yeah, like most.
No,
most
I don't
people
think
don't.
It's a good idea. And that's the end of it. I back off after that.
I didn't
but
know how to play it completely.
Bobby's little punk-ass thimble lands on my railroad like 14 times. And all of a sudden, things start to change. Ah, shucks. Another $50 for me. Boy, I bet you wish these railroads were yours. Don't do it, Bobby. Stay strong. I can't do it anymore. You still want to trade for my Kentucky Avenue?
Oh! You became the devil.
Okay, I'll take 12 houses on the Reds. God damn it, Bobby!
Wow. All right, that is it for Brew Stew board games. I loved it a lot. I'm going to be playing a lot of board games soon with my friends, and, you know, it's cool. But yeah, that's me checking out Brew Stew. Let me know what you guys think. Subscribe to the channel, like the video, comment down below, and I'll see you guys next time. Peace.